Good day to everyone. So today our topic is all about crime and its typologies as part of our topic in the introduction to criminology. So first, we will define first what is crime, because there are different meanings of crime. So one of these is when we say crime, it is any rational human conduct that violates criminal law and is subject to punishment. Another one is crime is defined as an act committed or omitted in violation of public law forbidding or commanding it. And it is also defined as an act that violates the law of the nation. But in legal terms, crime is an intentional violation of criminal law or penal code, because it is very important what we call the intent. Okay, committed without a defense or excuse and penalized by the state. And also, crime is an intentional act or omission in violation of criminal law, which is the statutory and the case law. Committed without defense or justification and sanctioned by the state as a felony or a misdemeanor. But within the social context, crime is a behavior that violates the norms of society, or more simply, antisocial behavior or deviance. So when we say norms, this is the standard or any standard or rule regarding what human beings should or should not think, say, or do under given circumstances. And the deviance, it refers to the conduct which people of a group considered so dangerous or embarrassing or irritating that they bring special sanctions to bear against the persons who exhibit it. And it should be noted that not all deviant behavior is criminal behavior. So what are the elements of crime? Okay, technically and ideally, a crime has not been committed unless all the following elements are present. First is harm. So when we say harm, for a crime to occur, there must be an external consequence or harm. A mental or emotional state is not enough. Thus, thinking about committing a crime or being angry enough to commit a crime without acting on the thought or the anger is not a crime. Kahit nagalit ka kapag wala kang action at wala kang nasaktan, walang krimen. Okay? So, the harm may be physical or verbal. Okay? So, next is legality. In this legality, this has two aspects. Okay, first, the harm must be legally forbidden for a behavior to be a crime. Okay, and does the violation of union rules or any rules other than those or of a political jurisdiction may be wrong, but they are not crimes unless they are also prohibited by criminal law. And the second one is, a criminal law must not be retroactive or ex post facto law. What is meant by that? So, ex post facto law, it declares criminal act that was not illegal when it was committed. Hindi mo naman masasabing criminal act kapag wala pang batas na nagbabawal yan. Okay? Another one is, hindi mo siya pwedeng kasuhan. Okay, for example, is nakapatay siya ngayon pero wala pang batas na nagpaparusa ng pagpatay ng tao, at kinabukasan ay meron ng batas, so hindi mo na siya pwedeng kasuhan ng pagpatay. Kasi nung nagawa niya yung krimen is wala pang batas na nagbabawal sa pagpatay. Okay. Another one is, it increases the punishment for a crime after it is committed and or alters the rules of evidence in particular case after the crime is committed. So that is the legality. Okay. Another one is the actus reus. Okay. Actus reus, this Latin term refers to criminal conduct, specifically, intentionally, or criminally negligent or reckless action or inaction of the causes harm. Okay. In this actus reus, crime involves not only things people do, but also things they do not do. For example, in this actus reus is yung mga magulang. Okay. Those parents who fail to provide their children with adequate food, yung mga hindi nabibigyan ng mga magulang na hindi nabibigyan tamang pagkain yung mga anak, clothing, shelter. Okay. These parents are committing a crime kasi responsibilidad ng mga magulang ang mga yan. Okay. So another one is the mens rea. So mens rea, this is a Latin term. It refers to a criminal intent or a guilty state of mind. Okay. Offenders who commit crimes with mens rea are to be held liable, but there are certain exemptions. Okay. Except in the following extenuating circumstances, like acting under duress. What is acting under duress? Example is committing robbery to save the life of a loved one. Okay. Being underage. Okay. A 6-year-old child who picks up a gun and shoots his or her parent. Hindi mo naman pwedeng kasuhan yan. Insanity. When we say insanity, mga baliw, a person is legally insane if at the time of the commission of the act, he or she did not know, okay, first, he did not know the nature and the quality of the act, or the person did not know that the act was wrong. Okay? Masasabi mong baliw yan or insane na yung isang tao, pag nung ginawa niya yung krimen, is hindi niya alam na masama yun. Okay? Hindi niya alam ang tama at mali. Another one is acted in a self-defense or in the defense of a third party, entrapment, or acting out of necessity. So in the necessity defense can be used when a crime has been committed to prevent a greater or more serious crime. But interestingly, the law does not recognize economic necessity as an excuse from criminal responsibility. Okay. For example, those employed and hungry thief who steal groceries cannot employ the necessity defense. So another element of crime is possession. This refers to the causal relationship between the legally forbidden harm and the actus reus. So in other words, the criminal act must lead directly to the harm without a long delay. Okay. Another one is concurrence. When you say concurrence, this means that there should be a concurrence between the actus reus and the mens rea. So in other words, the criminal conduct and the criminal intent must occur together. Dapat yung criminal conduct and the criminal intent ay dapat meron yan. Okay? For example, is suppose you call someone to repair your broken washing machine, and that person comes to your home and fixes your washing machine, and on the way out takes your television set. Okay, nung nagawa na niya yung washing machine mo, pero yung taong gumawa ng washing machine mo, nung lumabas na siya, kinuha niya yung television mo. Okay? So the person or the repair person yung gumawa ng washing machine mo cannot be found guilty of entering your home illegally or trespass. Okay? Bakit? Because that was not his or her initial intent. However, the same person can be found guilty of stealing your television set. And another one is punishment. So punishment for the behavior to be considered a crime, there must be a statutory provision for punishment or at least the threat of punishment. Because without the threat of punishment, a law is unenforceable or is therefore not a criminal law. So as the legal maxim goes, the what we call the nullum crimen, nulla poena sine legis, meaning that there is no crime when there is no law punishing it. Okay, that is one of the legal maxim. Okay. So in the Philippine National Police, there are three ingredients of crime. Okay. One of that is the motive or desire, the opportunity, and the instrument, not ability, instrument. Okay, but including ability. Okay, when we say motive or desire, this is the driving force. Okay, the reason why the accused committed the crime. Ito yung nagtulak sa kanya. This is the push factor or pull factor. Okay, bakit yung akusado ay nakagawa ng krimen? Okay. The opportunity. Okay, when we say opportunity, it refers to the time and place of the commission of the crime. Okay. Meron ng oportunidad para gumawa ng krimen. And the other one is the instrument or the instrumentality. Okay. We'll change the ability to instrumentality. Okay, these are the tools employed by criminals. And also, the ability, meron bang kakayahan yung tao na makagawa ng krimen? Okay. So, sinasabi natin na motive plus opportunity plus instrument is equal to a crime. So, that is the formula of crime occurrence. Okay. But the question is, when does crime exist? Kailan mo masasabing mayroong krimen? From the legal point of view, crime exists when the person has been proven guilty by the court. Kapag napatunayang nagkasala, napatunayan sa korte na nagkasala yung isang tao, mayroong krimen na nangyari. That is in the legal point of view. Okay. This view is based on the presumption of innocence as provided for by the 1987 Constitution, that only after trial and the proof beyond reasonable doubt is established by the prosecution that the accused has committed the crime. So another one is from the scientific point of view, okay, crime exists when it is reported. Pagka-report sa PNP, sa police station, na mayroong patay na nangyari, meron ng krimen. That is in the scientific point of view. So this is more realistic, but not all reported cases are with sound basis of true happening. Some of them are also unfounded or hindi nakita. Okay. So what is the difference between or the distinction between crime and sin? Okay, when we say crime, it is an act or omission against the penal law of the state, while sin is an act or omission against the spiritual or divine law, yung paglabag mo sa batas ng Panginoon, that is sin, kasalanan. Pero yung crime, yung paglabag mo sa batas ng tao yan. Against the state. Okay. So another one is the distinction between the crime and the immorality. When we say crime, it is committed against the law of state, while immorality is committed against the unwritten social norm of the locality. Ano ba yung mga sinusunod ninyo sa tribu ninyo? Okay. Crime is fixed by statute while immorality is not. And crime is nationalistic while immorality is regionalistic. Bakit sinasabing ang crime ay nationalistic while immorality is regionalistic? Okay. For example, meron tayong batas ng murder sakop niya lahat ng buong Pilipinas. Okay? Ipapatupad yan or i-enforce yan dito sa buong Pilipinas. While immorality is regionalistic kasi may kanya-kanya tayong paniniwala. Okay? Hindi po pwedeng yung paniniwala ng mga Yogad ay paniniwala ng mga Ifugao. Okay? Kaya regionalistic. Okay? Another one is the characteristic of a crime. Okay? Bakit ba ang mga tao or miyembro ng community ay interesado sa tinatawag na krimen? Why must members of society be interested in crimes? Okay, first, because crime is pervasive. Because sabi natin crime is pervasive because almost all members of a pre-society have been a victim of an offender of criminal act. Halos lahat tayo ay biktima ng criminal act na yan. Okay? Crime as an associate of society affects almost all people, okay? Regardless of age, regardless of sex, regardless of race, nationality, or religion, or financial condition, education, and other circumstances. So matatawag natin ang crime is pervasive. So another one is crime is expensive. Bakit crime is expensive? Okay, because the government and private sector spend an enormous amount of money for crime detection, prosecution, correction, and prevention. Okay? Gumagastos ang gobyerno natin yan for crime prevention. Kaya matatawag natin crime is expensive. Okay? Another one is crime is destructive. Why crime is destructive? Because many lives have been lost because of crimes. Okay? Like murder, homicide, or other violent crimes, okay? Some properties or many properties have been lost or destroyed because of robbery, theft, or arson. So crime is destructive. Another one is crime is reflective. Okay? The crime rate or incidence in a given locality is reflective to the effectiveness of social defenses employed by the people, primarily by the police system. Bakit crime is reflective? Makikita kasi kung mataas yung crime rate ng isang lugar, baka walang ginagawa yung police. Okay? Or baka walang ginagawa yung community. Okay? It will reflect. Okay? Another one is crime is progressive. The marked increase in the volume of crimes is on account of the ever-increasing population. Okay? The ever-increasing rate and their technique show the state of thinking of the society and its advancement. Okay? May mga innovation na rin yan. Ang paggawa ng krimen, meron ng mga, ang paggawa ng krimen ngayon is high-tech na. Okay? So, those are the characteristics of crime. So what are the advantages of the existing of crime? Meron daw advantages. Okay? While it is true that crimes are disadvantageous most of the time, for experts, crime also offers some benefits. Okay? So these are the following are viewed advantages of crime occurrence. Okay? One of the advantages is it promotes solidarity among people. Why it promotes solidarity among people? Because members of the community offer all their assistance to establish a strong front against crime. Okay? Family ties are become stronger. Okay? Groups become more united and solidified to fight criminality. Okay? So this is one of the advantages of the existing of crime. Another one is it prevents morality from going to extremes. Okay? Penal laws are the safeguard of our morality. Okay? When morality becomes law, they serve as reminders to society that something has to be done at once to prevent morality from going beyond its limit. Okay? And another advantages of existence of crime is it is a ratification of maladjustment. So, ibig sabihin, whenever a person violates criminal law, okay, such is a proof that his action is not within the accepted norms in the society. Okay? Crime is a symptom of social disorganization. Just parang sakit yan. Okay? Just like fever or pain, okay, is a sign that a person is sick. Pag masakit ang katawan mo, okay, yan ay isang sinyales na ikaw ay may sakit. Okay, kagaya din ng social disorganization na yan. Okay, ang krimen ay isang simptomas ng isang hindi pagkakaunawaan sa isang community. Okay. So I will now discuss to the crime typologies. When we say typology, it is an organizing device for categorizing large amount of information into mutually exclusive categories. So there are a number of typologies that are being used in the field of criminology. Okay, but to date, no universally accepted typology of offenders or legal categories exist. Simply put, crime typology refers to the type of a particular crime category. So, criminologist groups, criminal offenders and or criminal behavior into categories or typologies. So, they may be more easily studied and understood. Okay. Crimes are usually classified according to the degree, according to severity of the offense, according to the nature of the acts, prohibited, psychological characteristic of the offender, the career pattern of the offender, and or on some other basis. Okay. So, these are the general categories of crime. Okay. First, what is an offense? So, when we say offense, in the Philippines, offense is an act or omission punishable by special laws. What are these special laws? Okay, like Republic Acts, Presidential Decrees, Executive Orders, Memorandum Circulars, Ordinances, and rules and regulations. These are all special laws. Okay. So when we say offense, this is punishable under special laws. So what is the difference between act and omission? When we say act, any bodily movement tending to produce some effect in the external world, okay, it being unnecessary that the same be actually produced as the possibility of its production is sufficient. Ito yung movement of the body. That is an act. While omission is meant an inaction, the failure to perform a positive duty which is bound to do. Okay? There must be a law requiring the doing or performance of an act. So an example of omission is failing to pay taxes or the child support. Okay? So special law, it is a statute enacted by the Congress, penal in character, which is not an amendment of the revised penal code. So that is a special law. Okay. Another category of crime is felony. When we say felony, it is a serious crime. Okay. This category includes murder, aggravated assault, rape, robbery, arson, and so on. So, felony is an act or omission that is punishable by the revised penal code. Okay. Another one is delinquency, misdemeanor, or infraction. So, it is an act that is in violation of a simple rule or regulation. So, delinquency, misdemeanor, infraction ang tatawag mo dyan kapag ang violation, ang nagawang violation is a simple rule or a regulation, a minor violation of the law. So, it usually refers to those committed by minor offenders such as violation of the city or municipal ordinances. Okay, what are those ordinances? For example, jaywalking, spitting on the sidewalk, littering, certain traffic violations, including failure to wear a seat belt or a helmet. So those are minor offenses. Okay. So there are also classification of crimes. So crimes are also generally classified as follows according to Siegel. The first is violent crimes. In violent crimes, it includes offenses where violence was applied. So they are also called acts or crimes against a person, rape, assault, domestic violence, robbery, and murder. So this belongs to this category. So another classification of crimes, okay, is economic crimes. Economic crimes are primarily committed to bring financial gain to the offender. So the most common ones are crimes against property, such as burglary or the housebreaking, theft, okay, kidnapping, motor vehicle, shoplifting, arson, and fencing. In the economic crimes, it is classified into two. We have the white collar crimes and the organized crime. So when we say white collar crimes, they are violations of law committed by a person or a group of person in the course of an otherwise respected and legitimate occupation or business enterprise. So under this category, under white collar crimes, it is oftentimes in the forms of fraud cases, such as the securities related crimes, bank frauds, okay, frauds committed against the government, okay, consumer fraud, computer crimes also, insurance fraud, oh, yung mga hindi nagbabayad ng buwis, tax fraud, and other related cases involving deceit. Those are white collar crimes. The other one is organized crime. So this from the word organized, they are generally characterized by the use of legitimate or illegitimate businesses enterprise for illegal profit. So organized crimes, this crime type involves thousands of criminals working within the structure as complex as those any large corporation. So meron dun silang hierarchy na tinatawag, subject to laws more rigidly enforced than those legitimate government. The behavior of the organized crime, okay, is not impulsive, but rather the result of intricate conspiracies carried out or carried on over many years and the aim at gaining control over the whole fields of activities in order to have profit. Okay. So in organized crime, economic is the driving force behind the organized crime. Especially, they are active in goods and services that are scarce and illegal but have strong market demand. So like drugs, prostitution, gambling, racketeering, pornography, and other law violations in the nature of an illegal business primarily focus on profit. Okay. Another classification of crimes is public order crimes. They are unlawful acts that interfere with normal operation of the society. So, in this public order crimes, they are sometimes called the victimless crimes because they're is no direct or tangible and complaining victim. But however, some argue that secondary victims, what are the secondary victims? The family, friends, acquaintances, and the society at large can be identified. So, like for prostitution, pornography, drug addiction, gambling, public drunkenness, ano pa? Vandalism and disorderly conduct are among the behaviors that fall under this category, public order crime. So although the police treat them as minor offenses, but some scholars argue that they can lead to more serious crime. Okay, so what are the legal classification of crimes under the revised penal code? So according to the degree or severity of the offense, okay, felonies, when we say felonies, these are acts and omissions punishable by law. Generally, a felony is a relatively serious offense, punishable by death, a fine or confinement in a national prison for more than 1 year. While the misdemeanors, these are minor offenses that are punishable by no more than fine and or 1 year imprisonment, but typically in a local jail. So, according to the nature of the acts prohibited, so under the revised penal code, we have the malainse and we have the mala prohibita. So, when we say malainse, the term means evil in itself. They are crimes that are wrong in themselves. Okay? They are characterized by universality and timeliness, but that is, they are considered crimes everywhere and have been crimes at all times. Okay? Nung simula pa lang, itong pinagagawa nila ay krimen. Okay? An example of this is murder. Okay? Kahit na walang batas about sa murder, is kasalanan niya yung pagpatay. Okay? This is malainse, evil in itself from the beginning. Okay? But if the acts are inherently immoral, they are malainse even though they are punished by special laws, not by general criminal laws. Okay? Mala prohibita. Okay? This means wrong because it is prohibited. They are offenses that are illegal because laws define them as such. They lack universality and timeliness, timelessness. Okay, for example, of this mala prohibita is gambling, trespassing, prostitution, illegal logging, okay, illegal possession of firearms. Okay, ito yung tinatawag nating mala prohibita because there is a law, okay, na nagbabawal dyan. Next is, as to the manner of crimes, as to the manner crimes are committed. Okay? So, by means of dolo or deceit and by means of culpa or fault. When we say deceit or dolo, is when the act was done with deliberate intent or intentional felony. Ginawa mo yung krimen na meron kang intention. While culpa or fault, when the wrongful act result from imprudence, negligence, lack of foresight, or lack of skill, this is the what we call culpable felony. Okay. So another one is, as to the stages in the commission of crime, we have the attempted crimes, prostrated, and the consummated. When we say attempted, okay, the offender commences the commission of a felony directly by overt acts and does not perform all the acts of execution, okay, which could produce the felony by reason of some causes or accident other than his spontaneous desistance. That is attempted crimes. Prostrated, when the offender has performed all acts of execution that will produce the felony as a consequence, but which nevertheless do not produce the felony by reason of cause independent of the will of the perpetrator. That is frustrated crimes. While consummated, all the elements necessary for the execution and the accomplishment of the crime are present. So next is as to the plurality of crimes. We have the simple crimes and we have the complex crime. When we say simple crimes, when a single act constitutes only one offense, for example, is homicide or robbery. Okay, that is simple crime, only single act. While the complex crime is when a single act constitute two or more grave felonies or when an offense is a necessary means for committing the other. For example, robbery with homicide. Okay. Yan yung tinatawag nating complex crime. For example, gusto mo lang magnakaw, pinasok mo yung bahay, nagising yung may-ari, nabaril mo yung may-ari at namatay. Robbery with homicide because your intention is robbery. Okay. In a complex crime, although two or more crimes are actually committed, they constitute only one crime. Okay. When the offender execute various acts, he must have a single purpose. So another example of complex crime is throwing of hand grenade, okay, producing murder and multiple attempted murders. Okay. Next is as to the gravity of penalty or offense. In the gravity of penalty or offense, when we say grave felonies, those to which the law attaches the capital or capital punishment or afflictive penalties. So when we say afflictive penalties under Article 25 of the Revised Penal Code, which includes a reclusion perpetua, a reclusion temporal, perpetual or temporary absolute disqualification, perpetual or temporary special disqualification, or prison mayor. Okay. You must remember that if the fine imposed is over 6,000 pesos, it is afflictive penalty. Next is the less grave felonies. Less grave felonies, those which the law punishes with penalties which are correctional in nature, such as prison correctional, arresto mayor, suspension, and destierro. Okay. Ito okay, this is important that in less grave felony, if the amount of the fine imposed is more than 200 pesos but not exceeding 6,000 pesos. Okay, matatawag nating less grave kapag ang fine na ipinataw ay more than 200 but not exceeding 6,000, less grave felony. And the other one is light felonies. Felonies, those infraction of law for the commission of which the penalty of arresto minor or a fine not exceeding 200 pesos or both is imposed. Okay. What are the examples of light felonies? Is light physical injury, theft, alteration of boundaries or landmarks, malicious mischief, intriguing against honor. So these are the example of light felonies. But as to the basis of criminal act, okay, we have the crimes against national security and the law of the nations. Example of this crime against national security and law of nation is treason, espionage, piracy. Okay. Another one is crime against the fundamental law of the state. Example of this crime against fundamental law of the state, arbitrary detention or violation of domicile. Number three is crime against public order. What are the crime against public order? Such as rebellion, sedition, or coup d'etat. So crimes against public interest, like forgery, falsification of documents, or fraud. Okay, crimes against public morals, such as gambling and betting, or offenses against decency and good customs, such as scandals, obscenity, vagrancy, and prostitution. Number six is crimes committed by public officers. What are those crimes committed by public officers? And number one is bribery, corruption, malversation of public funds and or property. Okay, and number seven, crimes against person. When you say crimes against persons, such as parricide, murder, homicide, physical injuries, infanticide, abortion, these are all crimes against persons. So next is crimes against personal liberty and security. Okay, when we say crimes against liberty, personal liberty, for example, kidnapping, illegal detention, against personal liberty. How about the crimes against security? Okay, for example, abandonment of helpless persons, yung nakita may humingi ng tulong sa iyo, iniwan mo, di mo tinulungan. Okay, or persons in danger, exploitation of minors. Okay, trespass to dwelling, threats, and coercion. Those are example of crimes against security. Next is crimes against property, such as robbery with violence or intimidation of persons, robbery by the use of force, yan. Brigandage, theft, occupation of real property, or usurpation of real rights in property. So next is crimes against chastity. Okay, like adultery, concubinage, rape. Rape is already a crimes against a person. Okay. Next is another example of crime against chastity is lasciviousness, seduction, corruption of minors, white slave trade, or abduction. Okay. Next is crimes against the child, civil status of person, like bigamy or other illegal marriage. Okay. Crimes against honor, like libel or the malicious accusation by writing or slander or the what we call oral defamation. Okay. And the quasi offenses or criminal negligence. An example of quasi offenses or criminal negligence is imprudence and negligence. Or what is the difference of imprudence and negligence? When we say imprudence, it indicates a deficiency of actions. Okay, dito sa imprudence, it is usually involves lack of skill. Okay, for example, is if a person to take place the necessary precaution to avoid injury to person or damages to property, there is imprudence. While negligence, it indicates deficiency of perception. It usually involves lack of foresight. Okay. If a person fails to pay proper attention and to use due negligence in foreseeing the injury or damage impending to because there is a negligence. So, nagmamaneho kay iba, tinitingnan mo, nabangga ka tuloy. Okay, that is negligence. Okay, so these are the criminological classification of crimes. First, as to the result of crimes, we have the acquisitive crimes and we have the extinctive crimes. When we say acquisitive, when the offender acquires something as a consequence to his criminal act. Okay, meron siyang nakuha, that is acquisitive. Extinctive, when the result of a criminal act is destructive, that is extinctive crime. Next is, as to the time or period committed, we have the seasonal crime and we have the situational. When we say seasonal crimes, those committed only during a certain period of the year. Okay, like during election period, yan, seasonal crimes. Christmas season, yan yung mga tinatawag nating seasonal crimes. How about situational crimes? Those committed only when given the situation conducive to their commission. That is situational. As to the length of time committed, We have the instant crime and episodic crimes. In the instant crimes, those are crimes committed in the shortest possible time, yung mabilisan. While episodic, from the word episodic, episode, those committed by a series of acts in a lengthy space of time. Okay. Next is as to the location of the commission. We have the static crimes and we have the continuing crimes. When we say static, those committed in only in one place. Kung sa Kawayan, sa Kawayan lang. While the continuing, those committed in several places. Kaya continuing crimes. Okay. Next is as to the use of mental faculties. Rational crimes and we have the irrational crimes. When we say rational crimes, those committed with intention and offender is in full possession of his sanity, hindi siya baliw, nasa katinuan. While irrational crimes, those committed by persons who do not know the nature and quality of their acts on account of mental disease, yan na yung mga baliw, yung matang hindi alam ang tama at mali. That is irrational crimes. Next is as to the type of offender. Ayan, I have discussed to you the way already the white collar crimes. These are committed by persons with aura of respectability and of the upper socioeconomic class in the course of their occupational activities. Okay, this white collar crimes is also referred to as the corporate or occupational crimes such as ang example ito is tax evasion, stock manipulation, ano pa, plunder, bribery, graft and corruption, bankruptcy fraud, fraud against the governments, computer crimes, insurance fraud, and political fraud. And the other one is the blue-collar crimes. These are committed by ordinary professional criminals to maintain their livelihood. And as to the and the last one is as to the standard of living of criminals, we have the crimes of the upper world and the crimes of the underworld. Okay, an example of crimes of the upper world is falsification cases, while the crimes of the underworld is bag snatching. So, what are the other classes of crimes? So, we have the crimes by imitation. Okay, crimes are committed by merely duplicating what was done by others, yung ginagaya mo lang, based on the explanation of crime as alleged behavior. Okay. Crimes of passion, those are committed at the height of great emotions. Okay, yung galit. Okay. Service crimes. These are crimes committed through rendition of service to satisfy the desire of another. Genocide. Okay. This is a crime committed by a government through mass destruction or annihilation of human population. That is genocide. Transnational crimes. Okay. Violation of law that involves more than one country in their planning and execution. For example, is drug trafficking. Ang Pilipinas, nagbenta tayo ng drugs doon sa Japan. That is transnational crimes. Or yung Japan, nagdala dito ng drugs. That is transnational crimes. Human trafficking also. Okay. Another one is environmental crimes. These are acts that breach environmental legislation and cause significant harm or risk to the environment and the human health. Okay. Example is illegal emission or discharge of substance into air, illegal trade in wildlife. Yeah. Okay. Another one is cyber crimes. These are crimes that involve computers and networks, okay, like hacking. Political crime. These are criminal activities for ideological purposes. Okay, this is also serious violation of laws that threaten the security or existence of the government, like terrorism, yeah, treason or sedition. And also family-related crimes. These are crimes within the family. And the last one is the patriarchal crimes. And these are crimes committed against women and children in the name of traditional male dominance. Okay. So next is classification of criminals. Okay. We have acute criminals. These acute criminals, they commit crimes due to impulses of the moment, fit of passion, anger, or spell of extreme jealousy. Okay. Chronic criminals. So they are those who acted in the consonance with deliberate thinking. Okay. Chronic. Normal criminals, their psychic condition resemble that of a normal individual, except that they identify themselves with the criminal prototypes. Okay. Next is the ordinary criminals. It is considered to be the lowest form in the criminal career. Because ordinary criminals engage only in conventional crimes that require limited skill. Okay? They also lack of organization to help them to avoid arrest and conviction. And also organized criminals, they have a high degree of organization to enable them to commit crimes without being detected. With the specialized criminal activities operated in large scale. A force, violence, intimidation, and bribery are used to gain and maintain control over economic activities that includes various forms of racketeering, gambling, prostitution, and distribution of prohibited drugs. Another one is professional criminals. So they are highly skilled and able to obtain considerable amount of money without being detected due to organization and contact with professional criminals. Okay, they are always able to escape conviction, and they specialize in crimes that require skills. So next is accidental criminals. They commit criminal acts as a result of unanticipated circumstances. Situational criminals. So they are not actually criminals but commit crimes due to a given situation. Sometimes their criminal activities are intermixed with legitimate activities. Habitual criminals, they continue to commit criminal acts for diverse reasons due to deficiency of intelligence and lack of self-control. And next is the active aggressive criminals. They commit crimes in an impulsive manner, usually due to their aggressive behavior, as shown in crimes of passion, resentment, or revenge. While the passive inadequate criminals, they commit crimes because they are pushed to do it by inducement, reward, or promise without considering the consequences. Eh, ito yung mga tinatawag nilang nauudyukan na gumawa ng krimen. Okay. And the last one is the socialized criminals. They are normal in their behavior but mere inadequate and defective in their socialization process. So this group belong the educated, respectable members of society. Okay. And they become criminals on the account of some situations they are involved. Okay. So how to measure crimes? The Philippine National Police, as the premier law enforcement agency, acknowledges the important role of generating statistical crime data in the overall assessment of crime trend in the country. Okay. So there are two mechanisms in collecting statistical data. We have the National Crime Reporting System, or the NCRS, that is concerned more with the details of crime, such as the victim's data and offender's data. And the other one is the Police Regional Office Periodic Report, or the PROPER. and mainly concerned with what happened, where, to whom, why, and the result of the results of investigation. Okay. So there are terms to ponder or to remember. When we say crime, it includes felonies, which are violation of the RPC, and the offenses, which are violation of special laws. The crime volume, this is the number of crime incidents committed in a given area over a period of time, which includes the index and non-index crime. So as you can see, crime volume is equal to index crime plus the non-index crime. Yeah. Next is population. It is the number of inhabitants in a given area. The figure to be used is the medium assumption as per the records from the National Statistics Office or the Philippine Statistics Authority. Okay. And the crime rate, the number of crime incidents in a given period of time for every 100,000 inhabitant of an area. So another one is the crime rate. This is the number of crime incident in a given period of time for every 100,000 inhabitants of an area. So it is computed by dividing crime volume by the population in an area. So the result is then multiplied by 100,000. So this is the formula measures to the ratio of crime of to every 100,000 residents. So crime rate is equal to crime volume divided by population times 100,000. As you can see in the example. And index crimes, these are crimes which are serious in nature, which occur with sufficient frequency and regularity, such that they can serve as an index to the crime situation. So how about solved cases? So a case shall be considered solved, okay, when the following elements occur. Okay, the offender has been identified. There is sufficient evidence to charge him. The offender has been taken into custody and the offender has been charged before the prosecutor's office or court of appropriate jurisdiction. And when some elements beyond the police control to prevent the arrest, such as the arrest of the offender, such as the victim refuses to prosecute the offender. And the crime solution efficiency, this is the percentage of solved cases out of the total number of incidents, crime incidents handled by law enforcement agencies for a given period. So as you can see in the formula, crime solution efficiency is equal to solved cases divided by the crime volume times 100. And also the cleared case, a case shall be considered cleared when at least one of the offenders has been identified. There is a sufficient evidence to charge before the prosecutor's office or any court of appropriate jurisdiction. Okay. It is included in this category are solved cases. And the last one is the crime clearance efficiency, the percentage of cleared cases, but out of the total number of crime incidents handled by law enforcement agencies for a given period. As you can see in the formula, CCE is equal to cleared case divided by the crime volume times 100. Okay, so that is the formula. So that's all, and thank you, and God bless.